guys, Silver Game of Thrones is here. No, I cannot avoid this. Trevor, is it you? Yeah, are you still here? Yeah. What is my Bitcoin? Is it still here? Oof. Still my Bitcoin is still here? Oh yeah. So let's check it. Let's put it in computer and let's check it. Did someone steal it? You know. I don't know, guys. Maybe you have the same feeling, right? About this Bitcoin. Okay, so I cannot avoid it. I must talk about Bitcoin. I wanted to escape, but you know, this. I feel that I need to explain people, you know, a little bit. Especially, I consider myself as a highly experienced user in Bitcoin also, because I am IT person, and based on my work, I am also working with a blockchain. So I have experience in this. Also. In this topic, so you know, I'll tell you, from I'm watching YouTube videos, and you know, when I see some young chickens, you know, talk, maybe they have 10,000, 20,000, you know, viewers, I don't care, but you, I see some young chicken, they're talking about this, you know, silver and this, what, silver, it's so boring. And like, if you ask me, I always prefer to watch guys with 50 plus years of experience, because you really, really can get some knowledge. You really can get some education, you know, from people, from older people. I am 50 plus, because you know, so, you know, you catch this couple of years, you know, and when the guy is talking, I just can see that he is so young, you know, and he is like so young chicken. But anyway, so I have experience in blockchain, in Bitcoin, and I want to share with you so you guys better understand, you know, why silver, why not this currency, why not this currency, why not this, you know, because all these three topics, you know, are related to money. It's all cash, guys. This is cash, okay? So which one is better, right? So let's get some education from experienced guy. Okay, so maybe it will be 2-3 in our videos, so let's see how it will be, how you guys like or not, because I have 400 plus users, so I hope, you know, someone will be interesting. So first of all, blockchain. So I put here, do not invest in less than 20-30 coins, okay? So, because usually people try to, you know, catch the topic, you know, what a topic, what is inside, not relevant. So for these guys who just watch and they just skip, I am telling you right away, okay? If you invest in cryptocurrency, my suggestion, do not invest in first 25-30 top coins, okay? Because, you know, whatever they, you know, scammers will tell you, oh, this is the best crypto, blah, 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 prove it. So 25, 30 coins is already around, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 years, okay? So they prove, so you can trust them, you know. Whatever new is coming, who knows? Maybe yes, maybe no. I don't play these scam games, okay? So first of all, blockchain. You really need to understand a little bit about all these technologies, you know, to be able to invest. If not, then you will just follow other people like me who will tell you. But you need to be smart, you know. Why to listen to some smart folks like me if you can have your own idea? So blockchain. Blockchain is not a Bitcoin, guys. You need to understand. The blockchain is a technology by itself. So you can have, you know, blockchain for movies, you can have blockchain for some IT projects, you know, it's not necessary to be Bitcoin, okay? Blockchain is based on general ledger. So if you know what is general ledger, you know, ask your accounting, but general ledger, to make it simple, you have $1 in your pocket, okay? This is $1. You go to bank and you give them $1. So in bank, it will be debit. In bank it will be credit, because they have plus, so it credited, you credited the bank. In your pocket it will be debit. So it's two sides of the story, the general ledger. It's debit and credit, and debit and credit. It was always like this, and it was from, you know, from Attic world, you know. So blockchain is a general ledger. Okay, I'll tell you a little bit different why blockchain, not a general ledger. So the general ledger, which we know, is should be accounted. You know, you need accounting, and you need to see, you know, is it valid, not valid, you know, transaction, and we have taxes, you know, every transaction split it on four, you know, because we have credit debit, we have tax credit debit, so we have a lot of stuff there. So you need accounting, right? Blockchain doesn't need any accounting. So I start to talk about advantages, like pros and cons. So pros, it's distributed. So blockchain is data. It's stored on thousands of devices, thousands. It's a distributed network of nodes. The system and data highly resistant to technical failures and malicious attacks. So make it simple. You have a continent, Africa, okay, which tomorrow will not have internet. Still in the US, you will have your Bitcoin in your computer and everything will be fine. Let's say all continents will go down. On some island, you still have this Bitcoin. you will be fine. One computer will have this blockchain data and it can be recovered from the entire world. You understand how strong this technology? The guy who developed it, he was genius, right? Yeah, he was a smart guy. Stability. So again, the system is stable. You know, like if you have internet, electricity is all you need. Trustless system. This is what I started to talk about. This, you don't need any accounting, because today world, you need a lawyer, need accounting if something happened for Bitcoin, for this, you know, you don't need anything. You have your device, and you know your device, you in your device you have Bitcoin, you plug it into internet and voila, you on your own, you Bitcoin and the third party or someone you want to send. That's it. You don't need any intermediate person to help you. I'll tell you one story. I sent money to Canada recently, you know, to my son, and it took 5 days, and $60 to send $800. So it's ridiculous. It's crazy, ridiculous. It's heavy. It's ineffective. It's a crap. Okay, so you know, no doubt why people start to use Bitcoin. But it has disadvantages. So cons, 51% attack. If some know what is this, like if you can generate electricity, which will able to replicate 51% of network, you basically can own this network. You have more than 51%, you can open this network and you can basically change entire network, 51 plus 49%. And I know a lot of Ethereum, you know, not a new Ethereum, the old Ethereum, and a classic, Ethereum Classic, he was basically under attack a couple of times, I know, and this was the reason why they splitted Ethereum network on two. Yeah, so we have it, but on Bitcoin, really, the amount of electricity which you need, you know, to attack Bitcoin, it's, I don't think even US can produce such amount of electricity, so it's normal, it's very secure and very stable. As more network we have, as more computer involved, as less possibility to do anything with this network. The data modification, yeah, anyone can modify the data and, you know, and send it, but this is what they have. They have proof. They have proof. So any time when you pay to someone to Bitcoin with a Bitcoin, you need time. You need verification. As more complicated system, let's say here we have Litecoin, we have Bitcoin, we have Ethereum. Okay, I put your silver coins, which represent. It's not real representation. This is here. It's a real, you know, which store here. So every time when you send, some false data, it's going to be verified. And, you know, it based on, let's say, most complicated is Bitcoin. It takes up to 1 hour. Litecoin, maybe 10 minutes. Ethereum, I don't even know how long it'll take. But they do verification. And they minimum need some X amount of nodes to verify that this transaction is valid. Because if 2 cents, the same moment, okay, one should be verified, another should be rejected. The private keys. Private keys. What is private key? You have your house. Okay, this is a public, but you have your key. This is a personal. So I'm talking about private key, is a key to your house, because anyone who drives near your house can see, oh, this is the address, okay? So what? to able to come into house, he need a key to open it, okay, or maybe Zif, right? So this is the difference. You have your private key, and you have two addresses always. So one address is a public. I can share this address with anybody, as you see on my channel. I also share, okay, please make donation to my channel with Bitcoin or Litecoin, whatever. It's a public address. But I have my private address, which is like a key to my house, where I keep, you know, my Bitcoin with my private service access. It's only me. It's only I have this private access, no one else, okay? So this is a blockchain. Now Bitcoin. So what is this, friendship, you know, between Bitcoin and blockchain? So Bitcoin was developed because of blockchain. Blockchain proved himself that it's very open and public source and stable system, blah, 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 yada, yada. And then, you know, one smart guy, Satoshi Nakamoto, right? He said, okay, let's make Bitcoin based on blockchain, okay? Based on blockchain. So today, what these smart people, you know, all JP Morgan, all the stable coins, they say, okay, I want blockchain. I will take blockchain and will develop another Bitcoin, scam coin or stable coin. But Bitcoin was the first one. That's why he is so serious guy, because it costs $10,000 or $9,000 today, right? Because you cannot replicate to be first, right? So now we have 3,000 small brothers, you know, scammers, which try to replicate it. That's why I say, always look into top if you want to invest. So what are pros of Bitcoin? First of all, it's another technology, okay? And this technology has mining opportunities. So when you mine it, you basically, by mathematically, you can prove that I mined block of Bitcoin. From beginning it was 50, now we have halving. Every 4 years, I believe, we have halving. And recently Bitcoin has halving and he reached 625, six Bitcoin in one node. 625 Bitcoin in one node. So if you find a formula, if you find the right answer, okay, so you mine this block, and now we have pools, because you cannot basically, you know, in your entire life you will not find you cannot mathematically prove that you basically know the answer on this formula, only in pool. Pool is a bunch of people which basically united in one place. So let's say you understand, you know, the Bitcoin is technology to mine based on some formula. So you get your formula and you get your Bitcoin in the pool. So you get it. So what are pros? The primary draw Bitcoin for many users and indeed one of central tenets of cryptocurrency more generally is autonomy. Autonomy. I have this guy, okay, this guy is with me, and I don't care. I care F, you know, whatever we're doing, you know. I don't care. I just have it, and I can pay anybody, anywhere, okay, with a click of a mouse. I don't need authority, I don't need proof, I don't need any regulation, you know, who's telling me, oh, I need, you know, you need to do X, Y, Z, like this, all these bankers, you know. They will suck your money, and they will... Okay, I approve you to send your money, which you earn it, you know. There's no bullshit, guys. There is no... No bullshit with this guy. It's very serious, okay? Discretion. You know, when you feel your SWIFT, you know SWIFT, the transfer, month transfer, when you feel... You need to fill bunch of data. Okay, I don't know, you know, how many kids you have, maybe. They are not me. They ask every bunch of questions. When you have this guy, all you need is your public and private access. That's it. Your public and private access is what you need. And you can send money anywhere, everywhere, and to anybody. Okay, this is very discretion. This is very discreet. You know, no one asks you, do you have what you have, how you make this money, you know. It's everything here. It's all about trust. It's all about trust. I trust this network. I try this technology. I am doing this. It's all about technology. Peer-to-peer focus. Again, it's a peer-to-peer focus means it's a peer-to-peer computer. It's me and you, a network. That's it. So from my peer, I send to your peer. Let's say I want to send money to India, okay, to some of my friends. So you know how long wait go? if you send with a SWIFT system, it go to Switzerland, then maybe go to China, maybe then it go to India, and then, you know, every clerk, you know, need to stamp it. Yeah, you have, you know, peer-to-peer transaction. You send to your friend, it's done. Elimination of banking fee. Oh, banking fee. I told you, they charge $60 to send $800. It's more than 10%. It's like 15% they charge, okay? Here, I know one guy, it was 2-3 years ago, who sent Litecoin, and he sent $100 million, and he paid 30 cents. No kidding, guys. He paid 30 cents, okay? 30 cents he paid for $100 million, okay? So what else? Very low transaction fee for international payment. Yeah, I already mentioned, you know, the transaction fee, it's to non-existent. Mobile payment. Yeah, you have your phone. You have this app. You click on this app. Boom, done. It's like you can pay immediately, but it will take time to verify up to 1 hour. This is a disadvantage, okay? Because it requires more time to know. But this, for this, they have Lightning network. Now we have another top Lightning network. It's too much to explain, you know, in 10-15 minutes. Accessibility, yes, I is accessible. I have this device and I don't need anything else. You know, it's accessible near me. And if you're smart enough and you can remember this, you know, blah, 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 digits, you know, in your hand, in your head, then you don't need even this device. You can recover this device if you put in your head. This is why, you know, when from Venezuela, people are living in Venezuela and they have gold, and when they have gold, then they just confiscate gold. But if they have Bitcoin, they cannot confiscate Bitcoin, you know. He remembers this address and he writes somewhere this address, his private address, public address, that's it. You need private and public address and that's it. And you can recover this device. Or you need 16 words, you know, the keywords. If you have keywords, you can recover this treasure or whatever its company is. What else? Cons. Exposure to Bitcoin-specific scamming, for I already told you. There are so many scammers. Guys, just don't go for the cheapest and the greatest, okay? If you want to invest into, you know, biggest, you know. I personally start to invest maybe 17, 18, you know, when it was around $10,000. $10,000 is when I invest. So I am equal, you know, I am equal. And I, you know, I when I was investing, I was trading, and I was losing a lot of money. So I suggest, you know, do not trade. And one point I won, I lost, and I kind of equal and say, okay, enough for me. So I'm not playing these games last year or two. I just have my cryptocurrency and that's it. I forget about this. I don't care, you know. I know it's going to be one day it will be very good investment. Okay, maybe for my kids, I don't know. Maybe for me, maybe this year, maybe next year. But we are coming there, right? We are coming. Bitcoin has this. Let me show you the Wall Street market. You know, it's a philosophy. It has this up down. So I start to invest somewhere here. Okay, so it's like 10,000, like 8,000, then it went to 20,000, and it went down, and then it was here, now it's coming back, you see. So don't be this idiot who now meant to panic mode, and then, you know, I'm out, and I know many people are out. I have a lot of friends that say, I don't care, I'm out, you know. It's all about fishing. You know how to fish, you fish your fish, and you have a patient. And then you catch it, okay? This is all the same. So one day it will be here again. It will not here. It will be 10 times more, guys. It is coming 10 times more, okay? But who knows when, you know? But when it will be, you know, $1 million, then you know we are there, okay? Black market activity may damage reputation. Usefulness, yes. Black market, I don't know. Someone is saying that you know, fraud. They use it for you know, for some black market activity. I don't. It's not really. You can use for black market anything. You can use this cash for black market. You can use silver, gold for black market, right? This is not really susceptible to high price volatility. High price volatility. Look on market. Market fell this year 30%. Of course, it's high price volatility. What is? He is young. This brother is young. He is so young. He's like 10 years old kid. You know, he is 10 years old. Of course, he is volatility. Now think about Today they can, who, anybody who has $1 billion, $500 million, or maybe even $50 million can play this game, can play this game. But what happened if tomorrow Bitcoin, one Bitcoin will be $1 million? You cannot play this game anymore because it will be $1 trillion. So it will be stable. Okay, tomorrow it will be stable, but not today. Okay, tomorrow it will be stable. Okay, wait, patient. Hi, volunteer. No chargeback or refund, of course. You need to be a big guy, okay? Don't scream, okay, where is my Bitcoin? I send it. Okay, verify, always. Do verification. Send a small portion. 0001? Yes? Okay, 001? Yes? You know more. So you need to be patient. You need to see how it's going. And also you need to do the validation. Okay, this device, what is the code? Okay, my computer, what is the code? You need to be smart folks, okay? Not a stupid fish. Potential to be replaced by superior cryptocurrency. I hear the story for the last 10 years. Okay, superior, and still Bitcoin is the best one. Okay, again, you want to invest crypto? If you want to invest, I don't tell you must invest. Yeah, Bitcoin is Litecoin or Ethereum. I personally like Zcash also, you know, very interesting. But, you know, everyone has his own. But if you ask me, this is what I prefer, okay? I have something very not big in this guy, okay? Maybe 5%. But this is, I invest 10-15%. Silver and gold, okay? Because this is something you own it, and you tangible, and you hold it. What you hold here is, it's also hard wallet, okay? I know it's in a blockchain. By the way, it's not here, just you know. Bitcoin is not here. Bitcoin is on blockchain. I only have a key to it. Okay, so Bitcoin is stored on blockchain, and I trust blockchain. I have a key, so when I have a key, I can open my door and came to him. Okay, so it's very, very, it really hard to explain in 20 minutes. Environment ills of Bitcoin mining. Okay, Bitcoin mining in another story is you want to mine Bitcoin, but I personally don't mine Bitcoin. And I prefer to buy it if I want, and in auto store. So the lesson from this is 20 minutes already. Guys, you want to invest into cryptocurrency, okay? Be careful there, okay? This is much simple, much more stable, okay? Because you invest into silver and it's like 1, 2, 3. Here you need to be professionally educated. It's brain, guys. Here is no brain. This is a brain. And here is stupidity. Stupidity, a lot of brain, less brain. Okay, just to make it simple. Okay, guys, so I hope you enjoyed, and ask me question if you want. And I prefer silver, gold over any other assets. I also like Bitcoin because it's independent. And if I need to run tomorrow, I can move everything of my assets into Bitcoin and just run if I need, right? So it's more like a safe haven. And if I'm here, play small games, I can play with silver, I can play. I just like silver because it's so beautiful, right? It's so beautiful and so sparking, right? Really. Okay, guys, 20 minutes. Sorry for to be so long. I hope it was very educated. I know a lot of new viewers here. Yeah, I hope you enjoy. And I will probably do 1-2 more on this topic just to discuss. Thank you. Please sign, comment, and put your comments and hit this notification. Bye-bye.